On 30 January 33, Hitler took over and formed a government. And very soon he issued a law which said that any Jew and any half-Jew and any quarter-Jew was forbidden from taking any government position, either federal or state, in Germany. Well, I was half-Jewish from my mother's side, and so it was clear I could not hold any university position because all universities were state universities. I believe that is still the case in Germany. So in April, one of my two graduate students wrote me a letter. I see in the newspaper that you have been dismissed from your position. What shall I do? So I answered him, I didn't know about that. Please send me the newspaper, and I don't know about you. Well, do you have to find yourself a different professor? I anyway have to leave. And about a week later, I got a letter from Geiger, who now was quite cold and acted as if he had never known me, that it had been decided to terminate my professorship. And still a week later, I got a letter from the Department of Education of the state saying that I was dismissed. So I went back to Sommerfeld, who again had a fellowship for me and who gave me hospitality for the summer semester of 33. It was a tense situation, of course. Sommerfeld was very friendly and always remained so. There was one Nazi graduate student there, and there was the and there was also an American there, and the American and I often talked about the awful things the Nazis did, and fortunately the machinist in Sommerfeld's institute was very alert and came to us and said, kids, don't do that. There is the Nazi student. He'll turn you in if you continue to have such discussions here in the institute.